Discussing the first part of the Gandhian work, Key to Health. So part one of this work is about the human body. So after understanding the meaning of health, so we're delving into the aspects of a human body. So first, as we know, human body is composed of what we call the panchabhutas, or the five elements: earth, water, space or ether, fire and air. So these are the five elements which the human body is composed of. And Gandhi puts it that all human activity is carried on by means of mind, which is aided by 10 senses. So as we can see, there are 10 senses which Gandhiji classifies. The first are the five senses of action, that is hands, feet, mouth, anus and genitals. So these are the five senses of action, and the five senses of perception, that is of touch through skin, smell through nose, taste tongue, seeing through eyes and hearing through ears. So these are the five senses of action and perception. And interestingly, Gandhiji also notes the 11th sense, which is called thinking. So thinking is the function of the mind, and some people have called it the 11th sense. So this is what Gandhiji puts it in the initial part of the work in human body. Apart from it, the key aspect here is that in health, all the senses and the mind, so they act in perfect coordination. So this is the aspect of linking health to the senses and mind. So when they are in perfect coordination, that's a healthy state. So inner working of the human machine is very wonderful. The human body is the universe in miniature. So this is the key observation, that the human body is a universe in miniature. That which cannot be found in the body is not to be found in the universe. So this is aptly summarized in the phrase that the universe within reflects the universe without. So this key phrase, that universe within reflects the universe without, so aptly summarizes the aspects of how the human body is a universe in miniature. So it follows that our knowledge of our own body, so since we're describing the body to the universe, so having knowledge of our own body could be perfect. We would know the universe. So when we know our body better, when we know the understanding of the working of our human body, we would also know the universe, is what Gandhiji puts it. And but even the very best of doctors, wives, hakims have not been able to acquire this knowledge. It has been ages since the research is ongoing on the human body. So no one has yet discovered an instrument that can give us any information about human mind. So psychology today has advanced to such a level, but still there are gaps in understanding of the human body, human mind, mental health aspect, etc. So this was observed way back itself in 1940s. Scientists have given attractive description of the activities going on within and without the body, but no one can say what sets the wheel going, so how mind reacts, etc. So a very subjective aspect. Still research is ongoing in psychology with respect to these areas. So who can explain the why and the wherefore of the death, or foretell its time? So nobody can predict exactly such natural phenomena, be it birth or death, etc. So that is the nature of observation which Gandhiji has made with respect to the human body. So happy working of human machine depends upon the harmonious activity of various component parts, as we just discussed. If all these work in an orderly manner, machine runs smoothly. If even one of the essential parts is out of order, it comes to a stop. So since it is a system acting together, so it is essential that all the parts are maintained well. So for instance, Gandhiji says that if the digestion system is out of order, the whole body becomes slack. So therefore, he who takes indigestion and constipation lightly does not know the rules of health. So since one part is linked to another, so it acts as a system. So every part should be treated essentially. So these two are the root causes of innumerable ailments, is what Gandhiji puts it. So this is the first aspect with respect to the human body's understanding. So another key dimension discussed in the topic of human body is the use of the human body. So what is the use of human body? So answering this question through a philosophical as well as a spiritual approach, Gandhiji says that everything in the world can be used and abused. So this applies to any aspect. So this applies even to the human body also, is what Gandhiji says. So we abuse it when we use it for selfish purpose, for self-indulgence, or in order to harm another. So this is when we abuse it. So if we put it to the right use, if we exercise self-restraint with respect to our sensory organs of action and as well as perception, even the thought process, and dedicate ourselves to the service of the whole world. So this is where Gandhiji differentiates of how one uses and abuses one's own body. The human soul is part of the universal spirit of God. here is where Gandhi is trying to establish the connection with the God, the spiritual aspects. When all our activities directed towards the realization of this link, the body becomes a temple worthy for the spirit to live in. So it is up to us to realize this aspect is what Gandhiji puts it. So body has become has been described as a mine of dirt. So this is a key observation, where body has been described as a mine of dirt. So as we know, naturally, that if it is called a mine of dirt, and if it has to be put into proper use instead of abusing, it is first essential for us to cleanse our body. First duty is to cleanse it, be it the thought process or the physical aspects, and keep it in a fit condition. So this is a precondition. If something is described as a mine of dirt, to cleanse it and to keep it in fit condition, so that we are able to use it properly. So the analogy which Gandhiji gives here is the context of the mines of it may be any mines of precious stones and gold also have the look of ordinary earth on the surface. Once we get to the knowledge that it is gold and precious stones present there, so then all the activity begins to extract such valuable resources. The knowledge that there are gold and precious stones underneath induces men to spend millions and engage scientific brains in order to get what lies in those mines. So it is in the same way that we must uncover the dirt which is present in the human body, and then cleanse it, keep it in fit condition. So this is a precondition for one to use his body properly, is what Gandhiji says. We cannot take too much pains over keeping it in a fit condition of the temple of the spirit, that is the human body. Man came into the world in order to pay the debt. So whatever debt we owe to him, that is the Almighty Lord, in order to serve the God, and not only God, even the God's creation. It may be humans, it may be any creature in this universe. So that is the purpose of God. So since we have come here, we have to pay off that debt, is what Gandhiji says, the purpose of human body. So keeping this point of view in front of him, man acts as a guardian of his own body. So in order to achieve this debt, we have to take care of our own human body. So that is the context which Gandhiji says. So in that sense, it becomes his duty to take such care of his body so as to enable it to practice the ideal of service to the best of its ability. So in order to serve better, you must maintain a good body condition. So this is what Gandhiji talks about or shares his wisdom with respect to the human body. So hope this video was informative. So thank you for watching.